Hi there, my name is Jason DeWilde and I'm the head of audio at the Australian Institute of Music, and welcome to another Microlecture. Today at Microlecture we're going to be talking a little bit about how to take a session that you might have programmed in one digital audio workstation and move it to another one. Today's one we're going to be focusing on changing it from logic and moving it into Pro Tools. A lot of you I know working with it have perhaps composed in logic, but then want to take it to a Pro Tools studio and say, well, how do you go about doing that? Let's go and take a look at that. So as you can see, I've got actually a song programmed up here, just a very quick song. It's a long, so nothing major. But it'll give you a sense of melody, and it's on logic. Now, notice I actually haven't saved it just yet, because that's actually going to be an important thing. So I'm going to do the file save, so it'll save it for the first time. And I'll just save it into the logic folder, and I'm just going to call it Microlecture. Okay, now if I could just take a quick look at that, I just need to explain something here. We go into this folder, and into the Microlecture, and what we've got here, we have a folder that's got just simply the Microlecture logic session and some audio files that have made up that session. Now, that is good to start off with, but then now a very important step, whenever you're transferring from logic into Pro Tools, you need to one important step here, and that is called File, Project, Consolidate. Now what that will do is it will actually take all of the samples that have been used in all of the synths and so forth, and will use them now in the actual, to put it in its own self-contained folder. So I'm just going to show you, we go File, and we choose Project Consolidate. Okay. Now generally you can leave all these, but what's actually going to do is it's going to copy all of the audio files and all of the samples from the logic folder in the Apple library and copy it into its own folder. So it's going to do that. This will take a little bit of time depending on how much software instruments and how many audio files you're using actually in your song. Now if we actually take a look at the actual project folder now, you can see that it's going to actually have a little bit more because now it's got in the Microlecture folder here, which is the front, it's got the audio files and the session, but it's now got the backup, sample, instrument, sample. So it's actually created a much, much bigger folder. Now this is pretty much, that folder there is now a self-contained package. And that's what we need to be get back to in our initial stage. Okay, next step. We have our song here. Okay, so what we're going to do first is we're going to now simply just drag the end of the song project to the end of the project so that it actually comes up to the end of the song. At the moment, my project finishes at bar 130. So I'm actually going to make this one finish at bar 10, like so. Next important step. We now need to what's called freeze these. And here is how we do that. I'll explain a little bit how that works. Okay, if we go to right, if we right click onto the track, we choose configure track header. Okay. Now, what this particular screen does is it just shows you which buttons are actually going to be inside the track header. So if I remove the record button, for example, you'll see that it actually disappears on the track header here. I'm going to remove the input monitoring. I'll keep the music solo there. But importantly, we're going to enable a different button, and that's the freeze button. Okay? And now we're going to click done. Now, what happens? We're now going to actually just enable the freeze function. Now, what happens when we freeze a particular track? It basically means that any it pretty much prints out the track. It pretty much basically says, instead of using this software instrument like this particular track loop, it'll actually play back the track with an audio file instead. The advantage of that is that we're going to use less processing power, but we're going to use it in a slightly different way. So, what I'm going to do now is I'm now just going to enable the freeze on all the tracks here. So, I'm going to go to the beginning, and all I'm just going to do is just simply play the song. Right? Now, what you'll see is that the song actually plays very, very quickly. Okay? But when you play it normally now, but in fact, it doesn't look any different, but it is in fact playing back a little bit different. Let's go have a look, because if we now go to our microlecture logic folder here, we'll see actually that what's happened is that we've got a new file in here called free files. Now, those free files, you see there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 free files, and they correspond to the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 songs in the track. So what's happened now is it's pretty well printed out these five tracks and made them just simply as audio tracks. Now we're going to use them. So we're now going to save. We're now going to quit logic. Okay. And now I'm going to open up a Pro Tools system. Okay. Let's create a blank session with WAV and we'll make it 24 bits. Okay, and choose OK. Now we're going to call this into the Microlecture folder, and we're going to call this Pro Tools session. Normally when we start recording, we type new tracks, but now what we're going to do is we're going to go to File, and we're going to choose Import Audio. And here, we will navigate now on our way to the Logic folder. So we're going into the Logic folder, and of course, we're going to have to now navigate our way to the Free folder here. So here, I'm going to go to here, select all these tracks, we're going to convert them, and I will now import them into new track. Yep, we want to go back to the session start. And there we have it now, pretty much, our song. So, from how we have it in there. Imported our song. Now, it's going to give the tracks a slightly like weirder name, so we should maybe have a listen to this one. So if it's imported directly off the file, so we're going to put this in that one. So we'll just call this one Tint Step. We'll have a listen to this one. There's some bass. This one. So there you have it, we have a transfer from a logic session into a Pro Tools session. Now this is very, very handy if you're creating loops and beats inside logic and you won't be using your main Pro Tools system. So don't forget to check out our other micro lectures available on this channel, but for now, just go to the way, sign up.